name is Dade Robison, and welcome to Stuck in a Corner. We're back. I've got my good friends here, my co-host Fox Evans, and one of my best friends, Michael Freeman. Why don't you all introduce yourselves?
But you just introduced us.
I know.
I feel as if I'm here now.
I wasn't here before I was introduced.
I summoned you both into existence so that we could play some music and talk some shit.
Oh, hey, what's up, guys?
All I know how to do is play music and talk shit.
Yeah, man, wait.
Fuck, did I forget breathing? Shit.
He forgot breathing.
We threw out the breathing.
How are you both talking then? I'm so confused.
All right. usually transient particles that kind of like harbor their own existence out in the ether that you produce, and they just kind of magnetically come back whenever you lose them.
I see.
Yeah. Words.
Hi, I'm Michael Freeman.
I had nothing. Could not yes and that for like the life of me.
Yeah. And I'm insane.
You're nice, a gamer.
Nice.
That's
to meet
what it
you.
Is.
I'm not a gamer, but speaking of games, I really still want to play Cyberpunk 2077, even though everybody says it's
trash.
I do too.
No, I know what to expect. It started immediately. We were not anticipating this. Ignore the very chill music in the background. Oh, it's muted?
It's muted.
God. Yeah. It started playing for us.
Well, there was an experiment gone wrong.
Huh. Wow.
So, yeah, I was trying to cue up the music so that I didn't have to do it later whenever we went to play music.
Also,
so we didn't have any dead air.
And
also,
just
that like vibe in the background might have been chill, too.
Yeah, it did. It put me at ease for a second. No, yeah, I know what to expect out of 2077, right? Like, it got delayed for 7 years. It went through several different development teams. They crunched like hell for the last year. But I still want to play it. Like, if anything,
Project.
To patronize the
Project.
The developers.
What's wrong with you?
It shouldn't have been that hard.
Well, so here's the thing, though. They are handling it really gracefully. They're offering, they're like, listen, if you want a refund, go through whatever place you bought it from. If they refuse to give you a refund, email us and we will issue a refund. And they're like, we're issuing a patch in the next week. We're issuing a patch in January. Like, they're handling it as gracefully as any company could. Like, so I still want to play the game.
I do too. It looks so cool.
I'll
I mean,
play it in like 5 years when it's finished.
Oh man. Like Skyrim whenever they release the 19th version of it.
Well, I mean that's
that's different. Those aren't patches. All the bugs that the game was shipped with are still present.
The analogy isn't wrong though. Like
continuous iterations of the same game.
Yeah, I mean it's like, I don't know why they keep getting away with just re-releasing Skyrim.
Well, because
like,
it's a good game.
It is a good game, but give me more. Give me something new.
They have a sixth one
been
coming
working
out.
On it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Also I mean, been giving us what we wanted during the meantime, so, you
yeah.
know.
I mean, I would argue that Fallout 76 is not what most people wanted.
That, nope, that's not what I meant.
Oh,
like,
what
I was
did you
actually
mean?
Specifically talking about the upkeep in the fan base of Skyrim still being ridiculously strong.
Yeah, I mean the DLCs and stuff are pretty great.
And the modding fan base is still there. They're all still adding new content to the game.
Oh, for sure. There's some people that are like, I literally don't play any other game
except
and I haven't for like almost 20 years or something stupid. Not
when did it come out? It came to 2012, right? 8 years now?
Ooh, I'm not sure.
I think I was at least a junior in high school when it came out.
I was real young. It was the same year that my dad's lung exploded.
Oh, yeah. That's a
high school,
you said.
Yeah.
High school or college sounds about right.
Skyrim.
Yeah, no, I was at least a junior in high school.
2011.
Yeah. So I was a junior in high school.
I remember because my dad had just gotten it, and I was really excited to play it, and we were all going to watch him go through the character creator because it was like the newest in technology, and it was like a crisp December evening, and my dad started to have a asthma attack, and then his right lung, I believe, ruptured. And
hey, I've been there.
You've had your lung rupture?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Why?
The whole story is such a wild story that I'm not prepared to talk about right
Word.
Now. So please continue.
Okay, yeah. Well, I mean, it was upsetting to say the least. I was 12 in 2011, so it was I was a little young, and I was crying because I thought my dad was going
to
die.
Well, he didn't.
No.
You got to see Skyrim come into fruition.
Yeah.
So I guess that's the how we connected the story, right?
Word. And then Alduin showed up and was just like, Rob, and you're dead.
And yeah, and then my dad died, right?
No, God, no.
And Alduin then killed my dad.
And then I died after, and then so did all the other villagers in the Thatcher Roof cottages. Like, that's just how it got burninated.
The first time I played Skyrim, I didn't know that, like, I didn't know how the status, like, effects happened, and I didn't know, like, what was going on, but somehow I caught vampirism, and, like, it got so bad that, like, I couldn't cure it, and I was still very early in the game. Yeah, I was trying to go up to I was trying to go up the mountain to the graveyard.
High Hrothgar. Yeah.
And every time I would walk up to the graveyard, they'd fucking attack and kill me.
Because you were a vampire. Were you still trying to get, like, the first quest for that started so you could become a dragonborn? Well, that's cool. Have you re-experienced the game since?
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
okay,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, yeah.
The story
that's
is
a whole
so
vibe
short.
Where you're just like, fuck the main story. I'm just going to play this game the way that I feel like I want to play an RPG
character.
Yeah,
I didn't follow the path that you're supposed to follow. That's how I caught vampirism.
I debated between Millennium, either having y'all do like the wash up on the shore thing or making it weirder and being like, yeah, you're now being like drug around in like a net on a low cart.
Oh, and we have to figure out how to escape that. I see how you can work. God damn
you're
it.
Finally
Todd
awake.
Did it. Todd Howard got me again, you motherfucker.
But I was like, nah, we're going to do the beach.
What the Funcast presents, The Elder Scrolls 5 Skyrim.
Well, might as well go ahead and plug it then, since we've been talking about it.
Yeah.
Our newest episode of But the Funcast came out last Sunday.
Oh,
let's fucking talk about that
and
shit, dude.
Oh, my God. Dade?
That crowd in the beginning, right?
Dade,
like
that
the
audio
tension
quality.
As it builds up and the way our voices sound throughout the whole thing, it's top-notch.
Top-notch.
Very good.
The plugins that we got are seriously, like, top-of-the-line shit.
What was the plugin?
So we got the Isotope Holiday Bundle, which had, it was $40 for, like, 8 different plugins. They were the Essentials version of each of the plugins that I've found out since, so they don't include all of the features. Uh-huh. Like, if you got Ableton Light versus Ableton Suite, which is what we have. Sorry, brain fart. The ones that we're using are called Isotope RX. Uh-huh. Not sure what that means. I guess it's like doctoring, right? Doctoring the audio. But it comes with a de-hum plugin, a de-click plugin. So if there's like technology sound in the background, or
it just
like
gets rid of it.
It gets rid of that, or if someone bumps something. And then there's something else called de-clip. So if you're shouting into the microphone or something like that and it clips the audio, you can get rid of that. And there's like a de-reverb.
That's
noise
awesome.
Type thing.
That's awesome. So and we actually got that for Got Trash, right?
And it just happened to, I saw it in the bundle and I was like, oh man, it's got everything we need. It's got stuff for the music, it's got stuff for the podcast. The distortion plugin we got out of it was really cool. So many things you can do. It's basically an amp modeler.
This is not a paid ad.
No, this is not a paid ad. Isotope just keeps improving their plugins. I've been using their stuff for years as a musician and now as a podcast editor too, and they keep upgrading. It's never been a complaint from me for Isotope. Not a paid ad.
Set reminder to send an email. Be like,
to Isotope, hey, sponsor me, please. No, they would never. They've got Andrew Wong and
never say
fucking
never.
Adam
all
Neely.
Never say never. All you gotta do is make content.
Yeah,
just,
they might listen to
somebody
this.
Up.
They might listen to this episode specifically
this very
and
podcast.
Hear the amazing songs from the first two artists that we have coming up.
Oh,
Moon Type and Slinky.
Yo, wait,
hell
wait.
Yeah.
I'm so stoked. Hold up. Oh yeah, I forgot.
Okay. Yo, big shout-outs to Slinky, good friend of mine. We just kind of made a new song the other day. I don't know if you saw, I uploaded another track privately to the SoundCloud. I'll show it to you sometime after the show.
All right, cool.
It's really
cool.
But yeah, just big personal shout-outs from me to Slinky.
Well, I mean, yeah, Slinky's awesome because they're the bassist / bass six player of
Cosmetic Damage.
And they also make really kick-ass music. The song... I don't think we picked a song for them tonight, actually, so I'm going to go with that on the fly.
Okay.
But Moon Type is actually a friend of mine from North Carolina, Tristan Gaskins. We played two of their unreleased tracks last episode that have no names.
Ooh,
and
that were so good. I
so
really like those songs.
Unreleased track one and unreleased track two. And but now, tonight, we're actually going to be playing one of their songs called Hyrule Fields. So there's so many words that I learned from reading them, and Hyrule is one of them.
From the Legend of Zelda franchise, yeah.
So, yeah, I don't know how to pronounce words. But anyways,
mute.
Thank you.
quarterback. And that was Slinky and Moon Type with Folding Thoughts and Hyrule Fields. I said it correctly that
time. You got
time.
It.
Dun, 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 dun.
So, yeah, that was really interesting. The conversations that we had during that little breakdown of music was also very interesting. I think my favorite one that you brought up was the Poison Dart Frog mail order thing.
Oh, yeah.
Honestly. I kind of want to hear about that a little bit more, if you don't mind.
Yeah, we actually, no one, yeah, we did not elaborate on it.
Yeah, all I heard was poison dart frogs come in the mail.
Poison dipping dots.
This comes to us from BBC. This is how mail order frogs could save Colombia's amphibians. A large numbers of brightly colored poison dart frogs are smuggled around the world, but can a project that is hand-rearing the endangered amphibians help to save them? So it seems like, if I'm reading this correctly, we're shipping. I'm seeing now.
Yes.
I can see clearly now. The frogs are gone.
Police at, and I'm going to butcher this, Bogotá's El Dorado International Airport found a package with 424 critically endangered frogs, each with a black market value of up to $2,000.
Jesus.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. That's like four PS5s.
But this is this is an ongoing problem.
So what I'm hearing is the initial appeal that I had where I could order a mail-in poison dart frog is not correct. Someone was caught smuggling poison dart frogs.
No. There is a real project that's being started. I'm trying to...
We should read the articles.
Yeah, yeah. Well, this is one that Adrian threw my way in the middle of the
break. Well, I know, but I'm saying we should definitely read the articles before we start talking about it. I'm not saying like that's a fault on you. That's a fault on me.
If you had asked me about the new fish breed, I would have been able to tell you all about the new fish breed.
Yeah, well, you know what? I'm sorry that I
hey, so you guys ever like drink wine out of a can?
No.
No, I haven't.
It's actually not bad. I hated the Cabernet. It was terrible. But the Chardonnay is not bad.
I see.
I mean, wine in a can can't be good.
It can.
Oh, I thought there was more to that. Yeah, I'm trying to browse this article quickly.
Okay, I'm sorry. What about the fish then? They made a new
breed
of fish.
Oh, well, yeah, unfortunately. These two fish, the sturgeon and the paddlefish, I believe, have been unwittingly bred into a new species called the sturtlefish. Researchers somewhere in Russia, but I could be wrong on that, researchers were trying to see if they could induce a method of breeding in the sturgeons, I believe, that would not take... DNA from the male participant
like a female that could self-produce kind of,
I think so is okay. The implication there, but I could be completely off on that. They were trying to use paddlefish sperm as a control against sturgeon sperm, right, to see what like reproduction rates were like or something like that, and ended up making viable offspring. They made some like 400 sturtlefish and 2/3 of that survived. They had no idea this was possible, but it turns out that both fish have a common ancestor that was alive like 184 million years ago.
Word.
And they are called living fossils because they, I just realized that I was like really far away from my microphone.
You were still fine, like as far as.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
That's why I turned you up earlier whenever we started the show.
I see. Yeah. They call them living fossils because of how slow it takes them to evolve. So we just kind of fucked around and dropped a new fish.
Well,
new fish around, just dropped,
drop a
guys.
New fish, yeah.
How is this going to impact the meta? Is this going to make my gameplay any harder, this new fish?
I would 100% guarantee that if it did, it wouldn't be inherently its fault in any way.
That's true, but...
It didn't ask to be born.
That's true, but like...
Just like you didn't, just like I didn't.
I can't complain to the devs on this one, because every time I send an email to dev@world.com, I get, like, no response. So... I'm just assuming that our developer is, like, ignoring us. I don't know what to...
He's sending all of our emails to his spam folder.
God, son of a bitch. I've made like three different email accounts and
he
tried
knows.
To get
email.
Yeah, that makes sense. If he's the dev, he knows.
Oh man. Well, honestly, I'm thinking we're gonna go ahead steamroll right into our next music. Just because Alan Gady has not been on the radio waves in a few weeks.
You're right.
I kind of want to throw him up there. We're gonna do Elephant in the Corn as a it's a cover or that he did. He does his music as
Orchestrations,
and I can't remember exactly what the program was that he used. We talked about
it. Oh yeah, yeah.
And you knew what it was.
I said Sibelius, but I could
I don't think
be.
That was it. Anyway, yep. Doesn't matter. He basically takes it and turns it into makes sheet music, and this program plays the sheet music. So he's putting together.
That's cool as fuck.
Arrangements. That's the term.
That's the word.
Drum arrangements typically is how he does it because he usually uses xylophones and things of that nature for his instruments.
I see.
Okay.
So yeah, we're gonna be playing that song, and that's about a 5-minute long song, so it's gonna be by itself.
Hell yeah!
So
yeah. Oh, delectable.
Yeah. So here comes some music from North Carolina, and we're gonna do a
mute.
Thank you.
Honestly, I only listened to like the first 30 seconds of that song today whenever I was previewing what songs to play. So honestly, didn't expect it to go through all those changes. Freeman, what
it
were you explaining
vibes,
it as?
Yeah.
Like,
all right, so here's my big, big final verdict. Like, I dig it, and I think that to the person, what was the name?
Alan Gady.
Alan Gady.
One of my friends from back home.
Alan Gady. I think you need to hook up with somebody that like makes gaming apps, like makes apps on people's phones
and makes some like OST stuff, dude.
Right, because I think if you just chop up like the songs that you have, if you just chop that up, that would fuel like 6 months of like staggering content.
Well, now, so granted, that song specifically is a cover by a band called Nickel Creek. It doesn't sound like that in the actual rendition of that song, but that is a cover.
But with this style that you're doing and the way you arrange your pieces, you could definitely go into, if you've ever thought about doing original work, you could definitely go into...
The Wii Shop channel that they did is honestly crazy.
It's right, like, this is the kind of music you would hear on the Wii.
Yeah.
Like,
that's, so one of their songs is the Wii Shop channel arrangement that they did. They also did an arrangement of the Battle Kanto Gym Leader, like from
Heart Gold.
From Heart Gold.
Right.
So like they definitely are in totally in that style.
Into the video game stuff.
Like, this is... They're amazing.
This is your wake up call, Alan. Yeah.
So what they actually do, they teach drumline to high school students all across the East Coast.
That's awesome. Yeah. Okay, never mind, never mind. You're doing great for yourself. Don't worry about it. I got turned away by my high school.
You could always side hustle, my dude.
Oh yeah, no, he definitely is doing good things with his music and stuff for sure. Especially with COVID and everything.
True.
I feel like everybody's been making more music because of COVID, man.
I mean,
everybody's got to do more side hustle.
We also live in like the golden age of releasing music. You have access to some of the easiest to use plugins and softwares, whereas you used to need like physical hardware in order to make music. Anybody can start to create beats or make, you know, synth wave stuff.
Well, and think about how many podcasts have started since 2020.
Whenever
we first started working on making What the Funcast, there was a specific microphone that I wanted, the Audio-Technica 2100.
Right.
It was highly recommended from...
2 months, right?
It was highly recommended from every platform to do podcasts with, and it was sold out everywhere because everybody was trying to do podcasts. It was like it was on back order for like 2.5 months. So we ended up just getting some SM58s.
I mean, nothing. No shame to the SM58.
Hey,
sure makes good
I
microphones.
I think we've been putting out great content.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, they are great microphones, but it's
especially
just not what I wanted.
Especially for the scenario that we're in.
Yeah, right. No, for sure. We don't have like a sound booth. We have a couple of sound pads taped
to a wall.
One wall, none of the other walls.
That was the best we could manage. Leave me alone.
No, we spend a lot of time doing audio editing, though.
It's true.
Yeah.
Yeah. For the last episode of What the Fun, it took you how long?
Like, oh, What the Fun? Combined, I spent 8 hours on it doing the music, and I spent 8 hours on it doing the...
16 hours of labor.
Yeah.
That's 2 days of work.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I put it at least 10 doing the cutting on it.
Yeah. It takes a long time to get the cutting done.
That's wild, man. So, did you guys see that the... Negro leagues and the in baseball that used to exist before black people were allowed to be in Major Leagues Baseball,
right,
have now been counted as part of Major Leagues, like officially have been, like their records are being counted.
That's awesome.
As members of the race,
like retroactively.
Yeah, retroactively, the records of 3,400 players.
So the
holy shit, you did not give me that statistic when you first. That's a lot of baseball players.
3,400 players across 7 leagues
that never got recognition. You know, possible chances at Hall of Fame, stuff like that, awards and accolades, except from their own communities. Right?
And that's what this is going to allow them. It's going to allow these people to be in the Major League Hall of Fame.
That's awesome.
Like, that's a great step forward.
Yeah,
I mean, Jackie Robinson was the first
black baseball player in the major leagues. I can't remember when, but that was a really big thing.
Yeah.
And then finally, you know, whenever everything was integrated and the Negro Leagues eventually, you know, died out because that's racist as shit to have a league specifically
for black people. Yeah.
And like, I saw that today. I got really happy because I used to love baseball.
I did too. Like, I liked baseball up until I accidentally dropped my dad's baseball cards all over the room and he yelled at me. And then I didn't like baseball anymore.
I liked baseball for the cards until I found out that there were cooler cards like Marvel and Yu-Gi-Oh and Magic.
And so I never did the baseball trading cards thing. I played baseball.
I don't understand it. There's no game behind it, right? It's just collecting. Thing. Okay, yeah. And
it's like I've a status symbol thing.
That too, yeah.
Yeah, if you have rookie cards, rare print cards.
Have you played Yu-Gi-Oh or Pokemon?
Not competitively, just with my family.
So like with Pokemon, it's like, you know, you have a first ed, you know, shiny Charizard or Mewtwo.
Right,
or
that's
something.
Super big. Yeah, like yeah.
You can have a Mewtwo that's like the third or fourth print that's not shiny.
So there
but it's something different to have the first print. Yeah.
There were baseball players that were very fucking media popular, very talented, and had different score stats or whatever.
Right, right.
And they would mint those and make those all shiny and nice and then make those rare.
I see. So having them was really cool because they would only go up in value.
You would be the only kid within like miles that had it.
To have a Jackie Robinson card or insert any other baseball player name because I don't like baseball.
Yeah.
I know Jackie Robinson.
Well,
and that's
so I saw a really interesting YouTube video not too long ago where someone bought a bunch of packs of Garbage Pail Kids, the chewing gum with the Garbage Pail Kids cards in them.
Right.
And he was trying to go through and get like all of the cards from each of these boxes. It was like opening a pack of Magic the Gathering cards. Like, he
please don't tell me that he was chewing them.
Yeah,
he tried one piece.
Okay, thank God.
He tried one piece
because you gotta know. I totally understand. That's like when the dude drank the Crystal Pepsi after like 20 years. I would do the same thing. But then they re-released Crystal Pepsi, so I didn't have to.
I would get a very small amount, put it on a surface that is disposable, and then touch my tongue to it. And then
just to know if it tastes right.
I was like, all right, is this something?
He bit into it and it was like,
yep. Nah.
No.
I'm out. Fuck.
Oh, man.
Like the person that was, there was like, oh man, like a year ago or something, they found the world's oldest bottle of wine. And I think it was buried. I think it was buried like in France or something.
That's got to be disgusting.
So there was this. So whenever they found that, there was a meme. It was like, so they found the world's oldest bottle of wine. This is the world's oldest piece of cheese. Here's the world's oldest piece of bread. Let's make a cursed grilled cheese sandwich and drink wine.
You're not supposed to make a grilled cheese sandwich, though. I do want to know what a cursed grilled cheese sandwich tastes
okay,
like.
Okay, on the real though, if mummies or like other sorts of immortal creature were to like exist and those things, three things were gathered. Like,
oh no, that's how you summon the damn mummy. What do you mean?
Oh, I see you have gathered my meal.
Oh, thank you. Like, what? Did you think he was going to become calm and nice? There's an SCP about a mummy that when rehydrated, he becomes a normal person. Is that what you were expecting? No, dude, that's how you summon the damn thing.
No, dude, we were just trying to have a picnic, man.
Suddenly you've got the mummy on your hands.
SCP, what does that stand for again?
Secure, Contain, Protect Foundation.
And it's the SCP Foundation. Really good creepypastas.
Yeah.
Yo, wait. Hard.
Remember that one shot we did?
Screeching pies. What is gonna be our alternate content for Breaks on Between Millennium?
Oh, well, I had kind of assumed it was gonna be the like either an SCP thing or the horror campaign. That's what I was looking for. Horror campaign.
We haven't even like touched on.
I would love for it to be the SCP stuff.
That would be a lot of fun, and it would give me a lot of background to go ahead and jump from instead of having to craft a whole world on my own.
Okay, so I remember, like, I know yesterday we were talking about this, and I was like, I know we did a one-shot with the SCP, but that's like, the only thing I remember now is the SMD department.
Yeah.
I don't remember what it stood for. But I know it didn't stand for suck my dick.
Yeah, right off the top of my head.
I think that was the first episode I attempted to edit ever.
Oh? Did we record it? Yeah, we did. Yeah. I still have the file somewhere. I'll print it out for you so you can listen to it.
Yeah, I told you.
Print it out on paper.
Keep these for lost files. Like.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mm. Yeah, just let's just print out that audio.
Yeah,
file.
I'll get you a.
I'll give it a good read.
It'll be a 72 paper stack. All letter size because I don't have access to like making a book.
Could you
convert Adrian,
that
do you want to buy
floppy disks for me?
Convert it to a floppy disk? Yeah, absolutely. Let me go find my floppy disks that I just keep around conveniently for.
Yeah,
so
I've been warehouse too.
I have a new customer, and she, her husband, recently passed, and she inherited all of his stuff.
Dope.
And she's trying to give all this stuff to me, and I'm like, I'm sorry, thank you, I appreciate it. And she's like, do you want some CDs? And she pulls up this giant tub of blank CD-ROMs.
Yo.
And she's like, do you want these? I'm like,
blank.
Yes.
Kind of. Like.
Yes.
Blank CDs are niche.
Yeah.
Like, if you got those, you can do shit.
Like, okay, think about like some sci-fi futuristic type of currency out in space.
It's blank CDs.
A blank CD makes sense because it's a container capable of recording data to some extent.
So it can have value.
The only thing about that is CDs are biodegradable to a point, not entirely, but components of them are. So over time, they stop. Like the data corrupts.
But yeah, I mean,
unlike vinyl.
Yeah, but there's also like OGs on the internet and stuff. Also, okay, multiple ideas. First of all, you ever put a fucking CD in a microwave?
No, but now I need to know what happens.
It's
someone has on the internet. We'll find out.
It's fucking cool.
You know what I've always wondered? You know when people put like the chip bags in the microwave and it makes it super tiny?
No.
Is that real?
Yeah.
It is.
Well, mm-hmm. Styrofoam shrinks in microwaves.
There's a lot of problems with all those, like potentially death is on the line for those.
Yeah.
But also, what were we just talking about with
CDs as a
in the
currency.
Microwave and CDs as
and
a
yeah.
currency.
Oh man, I forgot.
Okay.
Well, we can go ahead and use that to go ahead and talk about some of music that me and you have made recently.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah.
Because we're going to be playing Ben Break.
Sweet.
Which is Empty Head, Dade.
My most recent single.
Explain a little bit about it.
I made it in a day, as I typically make most of the songs that I release to people, because I can't stand to work that long on things that I make for myself, or I get super into the details and stop, and I never release it. Right.
Right.
I'm glad that like you're so like affirmed and knowledgeable of that kind of a trait of yourself.
I know
as
that
an
I
artist.
Will spend too much time working on it. That's why I have an unreleased album that's only ever had listeners through this show, because I got too bogged down in the details and never put it out. So I worked on it in a night, or in a day rather. I was awake during the normal hours for once. I don't know really what the lyrics mean. I know what a couple of the lines mean to me, but I wrote them all on the spot based on vocalizations I did to the music. That's why there's only one verse and then a chorus that goes on for, if I'm being honest, a little too long. But I like it. I like the way it sounds. And then we got a really dope track that I'm really happy with that we
made.
So
there's a couple of things in it that I have noticed, and I want to take another take of it. Ah,
Fox.
We said it was done. I know we did, but I'm not going to do it now. Probably, like I said, in a month or two.
Okay.
We'll dust it off and
okay.
Because
we just got this new cool beat that we made.
Exactly. We
got
to make that one first.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're going to play Old Friends, which is my newest and only song, which Dade produced for me underneath the title Empty Head. And
oh yeah, it'll say just Dade on here, but that was an old thing, so
yeah, we'll update it. Doesn't do that next time.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's gonna be me and Dade's music up next.
Please enjoy.
Yeah, we're gonna do a little self-plug-in.
We run the damn show, we can play our
check
own
it
music
out. So here's the thing about self-plug-in: the whole entire fact that this thing exists is because we're doing it, and then the other things that you're doing that you can retroactively and like proactively plug together.
Yeah.
That's kind of how you actually.
That's the whole point.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
the whole
exactly.
point. Yeah, that's why I said shameless self plug.
Yeah.
And
there's
with
no shame.
That, shameless
mute.
Smiling, grinning, probably cause I'm sinning. I admit that you got my attention. Lots of shit, you got a nigga missing. Chose a different route, a different avenue. Left me here, but how could I be mad at you? Let's be clear, I'm better than a lot of dudes. Lose the fear,
an auto manual.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
That stuff is a vibe.
I'm hard fanboying over this Bloodbat.
I'm saying check out Bloodbat. Spelled all caps BLOODVT or BVT. Bloodbat.
Yeah.
They're amazing.
I am hyped for the next phase. Like, I want to know what they're going to put out next.
So
holy shit.
Phase two. And so these two songs are the only ones that don't have a different producer listed.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty sure that means that Bloodbat produced these themselves.
Which I love the drums on Losing Control. The way those are like hyper compressed and over distorted. That shit, awesome.
Yeah.
Words bad.
Yeah.
Are you saying that this isn't their final form?
It's not their final form. It's not their final form at all.
Big hype.
Shit.
And I'm so stoked for their next form.
Form?
Form.
All right. Form? Well, I just want to go ahead and give a big thanks to all of the listeners tonight.
Hell yeah.
It's been a really great episode of Stuck in a Corner. You guys want to go ahead and plug anything you got working on right now?
All three of us are working on What the Fun Cast. We talk about it every time. It's our sister podcast. It is our D&D podcast, DM'd by Michael Freeman right here. Us two are members. We play the characters as well as Devin Dixon, who is always here in spirit.
Always.
Big shout-outs to Devin.
I would like to say, since we may or may not be talking to people in the future, man, so for What the Fun, I've been thinking.
Yeah.
We could potentially have some sort of listener interaction, maybe manipulation or decision making in the plot.
So you want to try to do some live stream stuff in the future?
Live stream, or me, the DM working Harmu.
Damn, he just came back from the other podcast to meow at us. Wow, how did you do that?
Skills.
But yeah, just throwing that out there.
That's a great idea. We should talk some more about that later.
Yeah, but if someone hears this in the future, I'm always willing to possibly look into it.
Word.
Into what? Working with people, yeah. Like on the podcast. Got you. Like them them having ideas for the podcast and trying to get in. Got you. Yeah.
Word.
Wanted to say that today's episode of Stuck in a Corner has been filled in front of a live studio audience. wanted to say a big shout out to Dade's girlfriend, Adrian, one of the coolest people ever, for coming and watching us do this show live today.
Hell yeah.
And
yeah.
She is currently as red as a beet.
You could have been on the show, Adrian.
This could have been you in front of me.
Oh, the death glares are starting, so maybe that means we should wrap up the podcast.
I've done my job.
Thanks so much for listening.
And you guys have a good night as we do a
final mute.
Whether we're muting again?